I would say it's something of an epidemic, unfortunately. It's misinformation, it's the loss of context, the correct context, and it's deeply troubling to supporters of the Jewish cause and the Jewish state. Well, one particularly egregious example took place over the weekend. There was a deadly terror attack in Israel where a woman, 20 years old, was murdered by three Palestinian members of terror groups. And the BBC represented that in their headline as three Palestinians killed after a stabbing attack, removing who was the victim and who was the perpetrator. The BBC was forced to apologize subsequently, but this is a mistake they've made so many times before, and they've just got to get it right at this point. I think it happens too often. It's widespread in the United States and in Israel and even in Europe. There are organizations that have been set up to combat this issue. It's widespread, and the subject has been written about quite a bit. I think it happens far too often to be an innocent mistake. I think there is a culture whereby a certain narrative is imposed upon the journalistic community, and there's little room for dissent. And as a product of that, as a consequence, stories are sought to fit into a preconceived narrative as opposed to be a reflection of reality, truth, and the correct context, which is the ultimate calling of journalists. Well, I think, and again, a subject of our talk the other night, is that the good news is the media climate is changing quite radically, turning on its head, and it's entering a period that we call the democratization of information, which means that people, individuals, communities are able to engage in the spread of information. And I think my sense, certainly, is that the majority of people are interested in the truth. They're interested in justice. They're interested in accuracy. They don't have the time and the headspace for preconceived narratives. And in this new climate, a great opportunity exists for the truth to see the light of day, where people, individual people, you and me and our communities and our viewers, are able to participate in this conversation. And the same way that we're able to set the politicians straight when they get it wrong, we can vote them out of office, we can set the journalists straight and say, listen, if you're not going to be fair and accurate and balanced here, we're not going to spread your content on social media, and nobody's going to read it.